English Cocker Spaniel Cute Pets Review. Dog Breed Group, Sporting Dogs. Height, 1 foot, 3 inches to at least 1 foot, 5 inches tall for the shoulder. Weight, 26 to 34 pounds. Lifespan, 12 to 14 years. What's the main difference between an English Cocker and also a Cocker Spaniel, you say? Not very some time ago, American and English Cockers were thought to be the same breed. The decision to classify them as separate breeds was created in the 1930s if it became evident that Cocker Spaniels from the US were better than ones in England. One difference is size. The English Cocker Spaniel is larger compared to the American Cocker Spaniel. They also have different physical structure. And unlike the American Cocker, the English Cocker may just be found from the field alongside his cousins the Field Spaniel and also the English and Welsh Springer Spaniels. The engaging English Cocker is glad and affectionate. He's a sturdy dog which has a long, square muzzle, expressive eyes, long ears that make it to the tip of his nose when pulled forward, and also a dog tail. The English Cocker includes a medium-length coat, even though the English Cockers you see from the field possess a shorter coat than those from the show ring. They are 14 to 17 inches tall with a shoulder and weigh between 26 and 34 pounds. As sporting dogs, English Cockers employ a lot of stamina and they're also curious dogs and wish to investigate things. English Cocker Spaniels are fantastic retrievers with delicate mouths who hunt well in difficult terrain. While English Cockers are intelligent, they might be stubborn on occasion, particularly if they don't visit a good reason for doing what you wish them to do. Obedience training may be beneficial with any dog, though with hunting dogs especially, you'll want to train those to come when called and obey your commands. Because they may be so affectionate toward their people, you'll want to use gentle, consistent training which do not break your pet's spirit. Training likewise helps keep your English Cocker mentally stimulated. This is a dog that likes to learn. An English Cocker's talents aren't limited by the field. He can also prosper in tracking, obedience trials, fly ball, and agility. Because English Cockers are extremely people-oriented, they see being around their own families and can become destructive if left alone frequently without any companionship or activity. They get on well with children and produce good companions for folks of all ages. While they're alert, all of which will bark at noises, don't expect these phones to be effective guard dogs. They are much too friendly to the kind of work and a lot likely find yourself licking the hands from a strangers they encounter, even while wagging their tails. Highlights. English Cocker Spaniels can be challenging to house train. Crate training is mandatory. Some English Cockers bark a great deal. English Cockers are desirous to please and wish to be close to their own families. But they're hunting dogs and will start chasing birds or small animals when outside. Be sure to keep the English Cocker over a leash anytime you aren't in the fenced area. Teach him to get to you whenever you call. Cockers employ a soft personality. Harsh training techniques may make them fearful or deactivate altogether. Be sure to use gentle, consistent training for the greatest results. If your English Cocker isn't getting enough exercise, he might become obese and destructive. An English Cocker Spaniel's long ears are given to ear infections. To have a healthy dog, never invest in a puppy from an irresponsible breeder, puppy mill, or pet shop. Look to get a reputable breeder who tests her breeding dogs to ensure they're free from genetic diseases which they might pass to the puppies, and that they can have sound temperaments. History. Spaniels of varying sizes have been in existence for centuries. There are references to Spaniels dating back to the works of Chaucer and Shakespeare. Spaniels can be found in two types, land Spaniels and water Spaniels. English Cockers are people of the land Spaniel family. They place their name through the job they performed, that was to hunt woodcock, a form of game bird. Until days gone by century, it was not unusual for the single litter of Spaniels to possess puppies of various sizes. Breeders would decide what utilized puppies into their litters seemed most suited for, based upon their size, muscle, intelligence, and stamina. Toward the finish of the 19th century, however, British breeders began dividing the Spaniels into specific breeds: English Springer, Welsh Springer, Cocker, Field, Sussex, Clomber, and Irish Water Spaniel. All Spaniels that weighed under 25 pounds were classified as Cocker Spaniels. There was some dispute, however, over some from the weight designations, so eventually that it was decided that type ought to be more important than weight in determining the breed with the dog. In 1885, England Spaniel Club was formed. One with the club's first tasks would have been to create breed standards for each with the different Spaniel types. On one other side on the pond, the creation of Cockers took a new direction. American breeders selected for smaller dogs that has a more rounded skull, shorter muzzle, and heavier coat. By 1935, that it was clear that American and English Cocker Spaniels were two unique types. The English Cocker Spaniel Club of America was formed in 1936, as well as the American Kennel Club recognized the two varieties as separate breeds in 1946, with one being referred to as the English Cocker Spaniel, additional the Cocker Spaniel. Although the American Cocker Spaniel became very popular within the U.S., the English Cocker is one with the most popular breeds inside the United Kingdom. In the U.S., its relative insufficient popularity has helped the breed to stay healthy and true to its roots to be a hunting dog and pleasurable companion. The English Cocker Spaniel currently is ranked 74th on the list of 155 breeds and varieties registered with the AKC. Size. Male English Cocker Spaniels stand 16 to 17 inches tall and weigh 28 to 34 pounds. Females are 15 to 16 inches tall and weigh 26 to 32 pounds. Personality. The English Cocker is identified as merry and affectionate by having an equable disposition. He's playful, trainable, and friendly toward people, although sometimes reserved with strangers, as well as other dogs. English Cockers will bark to inform you someone's approaching, to make sure they're good watchdogs, but as typical Spaniels they'll happily show the burglar the location where the silver is. Like every dog, English Cocker Spaniels need early socialization exposure to a lot of different people, sights, sounds, and experiences when they're young. Socialization ensures that your English Cocker puppy develops to be a well-rounded dog. Health. English Cockers usually are healthy, but just like breeds, they're vulnerable to certain health issues. Not all English Cockers are certain to get any or all of those diseases, but it is critical to be aware of them if you are considering this breed. If you're investing in a puppy, get the best breeder who can show you health clearances for both your dog's parents. Health clearances prove which a dog has become tested for and cleared of the particular condition. In English Cockers, you should expect to determine health clearances on the Orthopedic Foundation for Animals, OFA, for hip dysplasia, using a score of fair or better, elbow dysplasia, hypothyroidism, and von Willebrand's disease, from Auburn University for thrombopathia, and on the Canine Eye Registry Foundation, SERF, certifying that eyes are common. You can confirm health clearances by checking the OFA website, ofa.org. Eye problems. Cockers are susceptible to a variety of eye problems, including progressive retinal atrophy, PRA, a degenerative disease in the retinal visual cells that progresses to blindness, cataracts, a cloudy film that forms above the eye, glaucoma, a common condition in which pressure gathers inside the eyeball, and eye abnormalities. If you notice any redness inside your cocker's eyes, or if he starts rubbing his face a whole lot, take him towards the vet for just a checkup. Hip dysplasia, many factors, including genetics, environment, and diet, are viewed as to help with this deformity in the hip joint. Affected cockers just might lead normal, healthy lives, even though you will have to monitor their exercise but not allow those to overdo it. In severe cases, your cocker might need hip replacement surgery for getting around easily. Renal failure, failure from the kidneys at the young age, between the ages of 9 and 2 years, occurs occasionally and is also thought to be inherited. Congenital sensorineural deafness, this is a disease that is found only in parti-colored English cockers. This condition exists at birth for affected puppies with degeneration of the hearing progressing to deafness with the age of 4 weeks. Some English cocker breeders are starting to test dogs for deafness before breeding them. Dilated cardiomyopathy, this is a disease during which the heart muscle becomes overly distended. It appears to affect primarily solid-colored English cockers. Signs include weight reduction, weakness, abdominal distension, coughing, fainting, along with a rapid heartbeat. Diagnosis is made from X-rays and echocardiography. Care. English Cocker Spaniels are adaptable, which enable it to even excel living in a condo as long as they receive daily exercise to ensure they are in shape. This is a breed which has a great deal of stamina, so he'll enjoy a long, brisk walks, games of fetch, or sports, for instance agility or flyball. Puppies have different exercise needs. From 9 weeks to 4 months old, puppy kindergarten twice a week is an excellent way for these to get exercise, training, and socialization, plus 15-20 minutes of play time from the yard, morning and evening. Throw a ball for those to fetch. From 3 to 4 months old, weekly behavior training classes and daily half-mile walks will come across their needs, plus play time inside the yard. From a few months to a year old, play fetch, which has a ball during cool mornings or evenings, not from the heat in the day. Continue to limit walks with a half mile. After he's 12 months old, your English Cocker pup may start to jog along, but keep your distance to below a mile and offer him frequent breaks in the process. As he will continue to mature, you'll be able to increase the distance and time you operate. These graduated numbers of exercise will protect his developing bones and joints. Teach your English Cocker using a gentle hand. He incorporates a sensitive spaniel temperament and won't respond well to harshness. Use positive reinforcement techniques, for example food rewards, praise, and play. He's an easy learner, and when you make training consistent and fun, you may be more than happy with his abilities. Like all dogs, English Cockers employ a mischievous side. They're also chowhounds. Keep food and garbage not even considered, and also anything else you don't want these phones get into, especially throughout the curious puppy period. A crate is a good way to counteract your English Cocker from stepping into trouble after you're not around to supervise. Feeding. Recommended daily amount, 1 or 2 cups of high-quality dry food every day, separated into 2 meals. Note: how much your adult dog eats is dependent upon his size, age, build, metabolism, and activity level. Dogs are individuals, exactly like people, and they just don't all need precisely the same amount of food. It almost goes without saying that the highly active dog will need a lot more than a bump on a log dog. the quality of pet food you buy also makes a difference. The better your new puppy food, the further it is going to go toward nourishing your dog, plus the less of it you'll want to shake into your puppy's bowl. English Cockers want to eat, and they also will down the pounds in case you are not careful. Keep your English Cocker who is fit by measuring his food and feeding him twice each day rather than leaving food out on a regular basis. If you're unsure whether he's overweight, together with the eye test along with the hands-on test. First, look down at him. You ought to be able to visit a waist. Then place your hands on his back, thumbs on the spine, with all the fingers squashed downward. You need to be able to feel although not see his ribs and never have to press hard. If it is possible tot, he needs less food and much more exercise. For much more about feeding your English Cocker, see our guidelines for selecting the right food, feeding your pet dog, and feeding your adult dog. Coat color and grooming. English Cocker Spaniels have medium or long coats which can be flat or slightly wavy, having a silky texture. The legs, chest, and belly are covered with longer hair called feathering, and not as much as that of the cousin, the American Cocker Spaniel. Feathering is in excess of decorative, it can help to protect canine's body from scratches and other injuries as they makes his way through the area. English Cockers appear in coats of the many colors. Among them are party color, white with black, liver, or shades of red, solid black, liver, or shades of red, black and tan, and liver and tan. Any on the colors or patterns may appear with tan points within the eyebrows, muzzle, throat, rump, and feet. Of all the English Cocker colors, blue roan is most in demand. Brush your English Cocker's coat on alternate days and anytime he's been inside field. You can trim the feathering so that it doesn't drag around the ground plus the feet in order that they look neat. The coat of your English Cocker show dog requires more effort. It must be stripped personally or that has a stripping knife. If you plan to indicate your English Cocker, you should apprentice using a breeder to know how to groom the coat properly. Clean the ears weekly, having a cleanser recommended by your new puppy's breeder or veterinarian. Because the ears hang down, they're at risk from ear infections. When you clean them, pay attention to signs of infections, such as being a bad smell, redness, tenderness, or itchiness. If your English Cocker frequently shakes his head or scratches at his ear, take him to your vet for the checkup. When it comes to ear infections, it is best to start treatment as quickly as possible. Other grooming needs include oral cleanliness and nail care. Brush enamel at least 2-3 times weekly to remove tartar buildup and bacteria. Daily is much better if you want to keep English Cocker's mouth healthy. Trim the nails a few times a month or when necessary. If you'll be able to hear them clicking about the floor, they're a long time. Short nails will help maintain your dog's foot in good condition and definitely will prevent them from scratching your legs as soon as your English Cocker enthusiastically jumps around to greet you. Begin accustoming your English Cocker to being brushed and examined when he's a puppy. Handle his paws frequently. Dogs are touchy concerning feet and look inside his mouth and ears. Make grooming an optimistic experience stuffed with praise and rewards, and you should lay the groundwork for simple veterinary exams along with other handling when he's a grown-up. As you groom, pay attention to sores, rashes, or warning signs of infection, for instance redness, tenderness, or inflammation for the skin, inside ears, nose, mouth, and eyes, and within the feet. Eyes ought to be clear, without any redness or discharge. Your careful weekly exam will assist you spot potential health conditions early. Children and other pets. English Cockers are friendly, fun-loving, and gentle family dogs who flourish with children, especially when they're mentioned with them. Adult English Cockers who aren't informed about children may do best in a very home with teens who understand the best way to interact with dogs. Always teach children the best way to approach and touch dogs, and constantly supervise any interactions between dogs and young kids to prevent any biting or ear or tail pulling around the part of either party. Teach your son or daughter never to approach any dog while he's sleeping or eating in order to try to take your new puppy's food away. No dog should ever be left unsupervised which has a child. English Cockers benefit from the company of other dogs and may also go along fine with cats, in particular when they're introduced when young.